Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, have you ever wondered why a businessman values the festive season so dearly and passionately? This is because he knows that this is the only occasion that he can maximize his profits. And the same applies to a believer. A true believer is the one that maximizes his or her obedience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the auspicious occasions of Islam. Once again, the Almighty Allah has privileged us and blessed us with another auspicious and significant occasion of Islam. And this is the first 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijja. We are now currently in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijja. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala personally takes an oath on these days in the Holy Quran in Surah Al-Fajr. The Almighty states, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَاشُرٍ. In the first verse, Allah says that I'm taking an oath on the dawn. Which dawn is it? This is the dawn that appears on the 10th day of Dhul-Hijj, the day of Eid al-Adha. And in the second verse, Allah says, وَلَيَالٍ عَاشُرٍ. And I'm taking an oath on the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijj. Subhanallah. The first 10 days of Dhul-Hijj were also given to Musa alayhi salam. Musa, Kalimullah, a messenger that enjoyed the direct communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His first experience of communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took place on the 10th day of Dhul-Hijj. Where do we find this? We find this in the Holy Quran. The Almighty states,
وَوَاعَدَنَا مُوسَى ثَلَاثِينَ لَيْلَةً وَأَتْمَمْنَاهَا بِعَشْرٍ فَتَمَّ مِيقَاتُ رَبِّهِ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلًا.
Allah says that we gave Musa 30 days of appointment. That after 30 days, Musa, you are privileged to come to Mount Tur and enjoy the direct communication with your Creator, Allah. Musa alayhi salam was so jubilated, delighted and excited. And therefore Musa celebrated these 30 days of the appointment in fasting. And these 30 days of appointment coincided with the month of Dhul-Qa'dah, the month that precedes the month of the Hajj. And subhanallah, when Musa completed 30 days of fasting of the month of Dhul-Qa'dah, he went and maintained oral hygiene. He went and brushed his teeth. So Allah reprimanded him and told him, Musa, you should have waited for our instruction. Don't you know, Musa, that the foul smell that emanates from a fasting person is dearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the fragrance of musk? Musa, you have spoiled that smell. So you are going to be given 10 additional days of fasting. Allah says, وَأَتْمَمْنَاهَا بِعَشْرٍ. We gave him 10 additional days of fasting on top of those 30 days. And these 10 days occurred in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijj. What is our obligation during these auspicious occasions? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam informs us in the narration of Ibn Abbas, which appears in both Al-Bukhari and Al-Muslim, that ما من أيام العمل فيهن حب إلى الله تعالى من هذه الأيام. That there's no actions which are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than actions that are carried out in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijj. So what does this mean? That means that we need to accelerate and increase our obedience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these auspicious occasions. And good action is a comprehensive word. Any good act that you can carry out in this month is recognized and highly rewardable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether it is the recitation of the Holy Quran, or patching up relationship with your family members, maintaining family kinship and family ties, go and patch up your relationship with your family members that you have not spoken and you have saved ties for years and decades. This is the time that you need to do it, and your reward will be magnificent in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the question that everyone is asking, should we be fasting the first 9 days of the month of Dhul-Hijja? Look, there's nothing wrong with fasting. But if you want to specify the first 9 days of fasting, then you need to have a substantiating evidence. So scholars have different of opinions. And this is based on two ahadith reported by our mothers, the wives of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our mother, Safiya, is an opinion that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam would observe fasting of the entire 9 days of the month of Dhul-Hijj. Where is our mother Aisha radiallahu anha objects this narration of Safiya radiallahu anha, and she says that I have never seen my Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam observing the entire 9 days of fasting, the entire 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijj in fasting. And the Allama Ibn al-Hajar al-Asqalani, the commentator of al-Bukhari, he summarized this fast. What does he say? He says that al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam would observe fasting of some of these days, and some days he would not fast. Therefore, there is nothing wrong. If you want to fast these days consecutively or separately, whether you want to fast first 2 days of Dhul-Hijj or the first 3 days, or you want to break them up, there's nothing wrong, as long as you do not miss out the day of Arafah in fasting. I hope that is clear. I leave you in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Astawda'ukum Allah alladhi la yadhi wa da'uh. I leave you in the hands of Allah, in whose protection is never abused. May Allah protect you all. Until next time, wa jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.